Jordan Brand has been flooding us with a bunch of craft shoes lately. And if you didn't know, the craft series is supposed to portray like a handmade and craftsmanship aesthetic. Now, some of them I really like the Jordan 4 Olive Craft. And actually, I do like the Jordan 5 Craft. These are nice. I like these, but that's probably because I just love Jordan 5s. Not really because of that craft aesthetic, but yeah, there's another one. And it doesn't seem like the stream of craft shoes is ending anytime soon. They're gonna take a pretty similar craft colorway that we've seen on the Jordan 4s and the Jordan 3. And now they're gonna put it on the Jordan 1. Air Jordan 1 Craft Ivory. Now the shoe is dropping on March 30th for $180. Thankfully for this craft shoe, they didn't raise the prices. Sometimes they sneakily raise the price for like craft shoes by about like $10 to $15. They didn't do it this time, so I'm glad about that. Now originally when the Jordan 1s first released, it came out for a price of $65. And back then in the mid 80s, $65 for a pair of sneakers was already super expensive. Now first impressions of the shoe. Number one, if they switched up the materials, I think I would like the shoe a lot more, and I'll explain why later. And number two, just looking at it, I think it's a clean and nice colorway, but there are just so many Jordan 1s lately, well, the past few years really. It just, I don't know, it just doesn't excite me. We've seen this kind of combination of colors on the Jordan 1 lows, I believe it was. So it's not like anything new, and I always thought it was pretty nice, but I don't know, in hand, it just doesn't really get me super excited. I don't know why. Usually I do like gray shoes. I don't like love that ivory color, but it's not bad. But yeah, I don't know. I'm pretty indifferent about this shoe. And the materials on the shoe, it is a mix of suede as well as canvas. Now, good news is the suede, it's not like that synthetic type of suede that you see on the shoes, like the Big Bubble Air Max ones that I just reviewed. That is super synthetic. You can feel it as soon as you touch it. This suede is a little bit more typical of what you would expect from a Jordan 1. However, the bad news is the canvas. This is a personal preference. I just don't love canvas on shoes. Doesn't feel nice. I don't like the look of it. And when dust gets in between, it just becomes very stubborn, kind of hard to clean, hard to get it out. I just don't like the look as well as the functionality of canvas on sneakers. So you see on the swoosh as well as all around the heel, up to the ankle collar, even the Wings logo itself, all canvas. And the Wings logo, it is like a patch that's stitched on. And what I hate about it is, look how messy that looks. You can barely see the Air Jordan. It's just so bad. At first, I thought it was like a QC issue with my pair, but you go on official images and yeah, it is just messy. I do not like it at all. And then moving on to the tongue, you see this kind of vanilla, almost pinkish orange color with slightly off-white laces or sail laces. And the tongue, it's pretty standard. It's just a nylon Jordan 1 tongue. I think that looks pretty nice, pretty subtle, nothing too out there. But one thing I absolutely hate about all craft Jordan shoes is this exposed tongue. You can feel the foam inside. I do not like it at all. If it rains even a little bit, I think that will just get really messy. It'll just destroy that part of the shoe. Maybe it's like water resistant, I'm not too sure. Never risked it, but I just don't like how that looks. Don't like it at all. And the Jordan 1s comes with a rubber cup sole with a Nike Air unit on the heel. And you actually see up close, not quite sure if it shows very obviously on camera, but you can see like these speckles of blue. So pretty subtle detail there. Not exactly sure what that's going for, but I don't hate how it looks. Kind of gives it like a more aquatic theme, I guess. Maybe I'm stretching it, but yeah, don't hate it. And of course, the iconic Jordan 1 rubber outsole and that same kind of pale ivory color. And this shoe doesn't come with any extra laces, just these kind of pale ivory, vanilla, sail type of color laces. And I think it goes pretty well with the rest of the shoe. Maybe white would be the only other color that I would go for, but the laces out of the box, I think that does the job. And the insole of the shoe, a pretty standard Jordan 1 insole with gray Nike Air branding. It's actually not a dream cell insole. Not the best at all. And the box of the shoe, this ivory yellowish colored Jordan 1 box. I think for craft shoes, they should just maybe do something special with the box, like a deconstructed type of box. I don't know, give it a different texture, just change things up a little bit. Now, in terms of sizing and comfort, I'm a size 9.5 true to size. For Jordan 1s, I stick true to size. For whatever reason, it's just a tiny bit stiffer coming out of the box. Not by a huge amount, just a little bit. Probably because of the materials chosen. Suede is just a form of leather, so breaking it in, it should be fine. In terms of the cushioning, a rubber cup sole, it is pretty heavy, at least compared to modern day standards. One Nike Air unit on the heel, you can barely feel it. Overall, for casual use, it's not the worst. But if I was going on like a week-long vacation and I could only pick one pair of shoes, the Jordan 1s would definitely not be my choice. Definitely not this one. And that brings the total sole score of the Air Jordan 1 Ivory Craft to 22 out of 40. Pretty average score compared to other general releases. Now in terms of colorway, I don't think the colorway is that bad, but just seeing so many Jordan 1s as well as the Jordan 3s and 2s lately, just feel like if we didn't see as many, this would probably get me a little bit more excited. But yeah, I like gray shoes. I don't mind this tinge of ivory. But together, I don't know, just doesn't excite me that much. It's a nice colorway, but nothing great. Now, in terms of the materials, the canvas is just personal preference. I don't love it. It just is stiffer. It's harder to clean. I don't like the look of it. The suede, I don't think it's like the best suede ever. There's suede that's like a lot more plush. Personally, I think suede from like the Kith Toronto's, those are better suede. So the materials, if you like craft, I think you'll like it. In terms of the comfort of the shoe, like I mentioned before, for some reason, this shoe, probably because of the materials chosen, just feels slightly stiffer than usual. Not by a whole lot, but with some Brigham time, it should be fine. But overall, the Jordan 1's just not a very comfortable shoe. The cushioning is barely there, it's pretty ancient, very flat to the ground, but for casual use, it does the job. Now, in terms of the versatility of the shoe, I think the Jordan 1 is undoubtedly probably the most wearable Jordan brand shoe ever. And in terms of the wearability of the colorway, nearly all gray shoe, I think that's very easy to wear. This ivory type of color is pretty subtle as well, almost close to like sail, which is very popular, very wearable. So at least in terms of the versatility, this is a very easy to wear shoe. Nothing much to complain about. Like a lot of Jordan 1s and 3s lately, I just kind of been feeling kind of indifferent and neutral about them. Maybe it's because we've just seen so many of them, it's overloaded, oversaturated. Sometimes distance makes the heart grow fonder. But I thought I would really like this shoe, at least upon images. I thought it would look really nice, but when I got it and I saw it in hand, it just kind of left me feeling empty. It is what it is, but that's kind of how I feel when I got the shoe in hand. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 1 Craft Ivory. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.